I'm pretty sure you're asking why I'm not in the GTS. There's a Pokemon I actually asked for my ninja. Which was this Pokemon Hunter. I couldn't get it, of course, get it in the next area, but I need a Hunter specific from the GTS, because, well, if you do trade a Hunter over, you get this team. An evolution. And I do need a Gengar for something I'm getting next. Also, well, if you know what happened last time, we battled against eliminate Pokemon. You see. This time we are going and also battle against Clemens. And also which also gave a lot of areas in the new city, so I'm unable to go anywhere I want to go, especially as well as my son. Yep, that is also why I'm not actually moving outside. Hello there! I wanted to talk to you for a little bit. Could you come over to Lysander Cafe? Yes, I finally got its name. I watched the anime a little bit. Do you know where it is? You can see it right from outside the Pokemon Center right by Prison Tower. It's the Red Cafe. Just hop in the taxi, you can find it. We'll be seeing you soon. I'm not going to do that. Taxi, of course, is just cheap for some reason. But I'm not going to do that, because it's literally we start like really right here, and also want to deal with my Pokemon, because they got hurt! Okay, I'm almost halfway through the game. Yeah, it's so short of amount of time, but it's good, that's okay. Let's see, nothing else here? No. What do you have to say? Looks a little suspicious. Have you heard of Team Plasma? Apparently it was making news a while back in the Unova region. Okay, nice, once again we're talking about a Unova of all things. Of course the sign of going to the Lysander Cafe is that Team Playground there. Over here! I was just having a conversation with Lysander about Mega Evolution. I would really like to congratulate you as well. Mega Evolution is something I too would like to be able to use. Actually, Lysander himself is a loyal ancestry. You two need to join the one. True, I am a descendant of the king's younger brother. That being said, that story is 3,000 years old. So it might not be entirely reliable. By the way, Zekrom, do you know where the holocaust is made? Yes. That's right, they're made in Lysander Labs. Lysander is a Gradium man. He supports Gradium Pokemon research with some of the profits from the holocaster. People can divide it in two groups. Those who give and those who take. It's just how the Kalos leads to a legendary Pokemon game alive and took alive. I want to be the person, kind of person who gives. But in this world, some foolish humans exist who would show their strength by taking what isn't theirs. They're filth! Long, long ago, the King of Kalos sought to take everything for his own, and he created a terrible weapon. And then the fire of destruction was unleashed. That's the lesson that I can pass down. Kalos is beautiful right now. There will be no foolish actions of it. I have a quick decision. That being said, the future is decided. You can't be sure each day will be like the one before. What the king did was reprehensible, but the ultimate weapon did manage to wash the world clean of the Eris film. Obtain a king's walk. Thank you for listening. Take that as an apology for taking up your time. What a passionate person. He's just like a blazing flame. Perhaps his pride in his lineage is what makes him burn so intensely. That being said, what Lysander says is is only one way of looking at things. It's not necessarily the truth. Second, what's truly important is the time you spend together with others. Treasure these moments. Spend traveling in your college region with your Pokemon. Now, the King's Rock allows Slowpoke to evolve into Slowpoke and other Pokemon, but also it allows, gives you a chance of getting a belt. Hey, it's Tress. Hello, how have you been? I just wanted to let you know we're all going to meet on Rock 14. Please come and join us. Oh yeah, I should actually grab my bicycle and show like all these stuff before we're going to Rock 14. It's actually completely north. Like, I love the color red, so it made this thing a little bit easier. Not much except for a little cafe and all that. And this is, yeah, just simple cafe Pokemon and me, okay. That's a juice bar. Rogue Plaza. Oh, Rogue Plaza has a, gonna be bigger now, you know, I like to stop eating good. Okay, so Hibernal, that's once again a cafe. There's a little bit of a restaurant here, that I can say. Not much stop. I want to stand on the Twin Tower. Well, don't die from that. Well, we actually did manage to do that in Super Smash Bros. Yes, Prison Tower was a place in Super Smash Bros. There is a Pokemon, there's some of there is a Pokemon. It's hard to stand in during a Pokemon, not want to make Pokemon cry, isn't it? I want to go this way. Yeah, here it is. There is also yet another set of shops here. If you find it. There's Chim for Furfru, there is a of course the herbs, and there's of course that. There's of course the boutique. Go this way, of course, Blue Plaza. Ethical Avenue, let's see what this one is. This is the Lumia's Press, which where Lisa is. Yeah, that's a Lotto. A Lotto allows you to get a little bit more stylish points, and it'll get free items. So, let's see. Let's see. Good luck. Didn't get a match. Do this again. For me. For me. But, yeah, even if you lose, you still get a few stylish points. Let's play with low, so now I got that out of the way. I should get myself busy with this one. I'm gonna do all I want today, and there's also some stuff here. But, another boulevard, but there's not much to talk about. But, what I do want to talk about, I just really barely remember that. There is a hidden Easter egg here. Let me see, it's a big black one, it's probably this one. Do you have to say? You know what it's for? Okay, good, good, good. This is an Easter egg. If we go, let's see, the third floor? Oh, there should be a place. Okay, this, no, this place is filled with, these people. So, let's go to the second floor.
No, you're not the one.
And that's Easter egg. There's a hidden, this is a ghost hex maniac here. I like this. Huge booming plays of happiness and cheer, and then there's this bursting music of fun comes this music along. Hello, Pickle Ketchup! Oh, I believe you wanted. You arrive very quickly. Behind the companion trail, we were just comparing how completing our Pokedexes are. I won, of course. I'll leave filling up the Pokedex to you guys, Trevor. I don't like it when everyone is doing the same thing anyway. Here's that. Let's compare how many Pokemon you've seen, just like we always do. This side is clear how many we've seen in the Mountain God Pokedex. I am challenging through my own kind of Pokemon battle. So see 10 Pokemon in the how loud, how frustrating. Oh, so you've seen Gible too, Mr. Confused Owl. Just knowing about the same kind of Pokemon. Just knowing about the same Pokemon as someone else can sure make you happy. Maybe a moment, this is part 14, right? Yeah, it's 14. No, mastery, for my memory is sticky, right, 14. Found it. Also, I love what's going on there with the music, just because of it. There sure are many kinds of Pokemon colors. Now it's my turn! Yes, it's this music. Time for Pokemon battle. Now it's my turn. Let's have a Pokemon battle, Zekrom. Yes, Psychic type, T9 Force ability, Psychic, Fake Out, Dissonant Voice, and Light Screen. Just to get myself safe, I'm pretty sure she doesn't want me. Not going to. Yep, she's using Fake Out. I was kinda. Dissonant Voice. It's a fairy type move, so. She always likes this panda move for some reason. No. Lucky I'm a steel type too. I'm a special pistol down. I'm not going to let myself bone there. Now, if I'm to back on any indication, I have been cheating. Oh no, you don't see that. But since I'm playing with a black GDS, excel. Music. Okay, Bunny. Well, I leveled up. Nice. Level 40. Pretty close. That's not. I just don't want my attitude to fade anymore. Hopefully, it becomes a little bit useless for now. Because I know the next gen is freaking fairy type. So I need Charizard for this. Also, that kind of reminds me to actually talk about, you cannot, Mega Evolution, you can only use once per battle. If the one faints, you can do the other one. They actually show that in the anime, that the stone is glowing when it happens, and when the battle is ended, the stone loses its shine. Yep. Absol! Dark type! Oh wait, did I actually say not about Chestnut? I did not say about Chestnut! Chestnut grass fighting type is overgrowth for its ability, Seed Bomb Fight. If you have chosen Fennekin, you will fight against Greninja, one of Dark type's going for its ability. Quick attack, no, just look at it since I kind of let him do. Take a hand of Water Shuriken, and if this Chespin, you will fight against Zelfar, Fire Psychic type, Exciting and Mystical Fire. Yep, I have not thought about those, about Chestnut. My bad. But Absol is a Dark type with Super Luck Force ability, Slash, Swords, then Quick Attack and Bite. Oh boy, home it goes. Screwed over that guy. My bad. I really enjoy battling with you, but I'm getting tired of losing every time. Wow, that was a really intense battle. Oh, hi, Sean. When did you start watching? So, last journey. He's at the fighting dojo. Are they the fighting dojo? Time late, everybody. I was having so much fun with the sparing dance that I totally lost track of time. So, do you know, have you found any good Pokemon for your dance team? Yep, I sure did. I'm still close to my ideal dance team. That's great, good for you. Hey, everybody, let's go to the scary house. The one by Laver City? That's just a rumor, isn't it? Come on, let's all go find out if the rumor is true or not. I think I passed. I'm sure it's just a rumor, but I want to spend some time with my Pokemon before heading to Laver City. Give me a moment. Okay, bye! Is it really okay? Let's go and see for ourselves, Tina. Let's not be some waste and rumors like that get started. Why are you traveling, Zekom? Everyone's working really hard on what they want to do. I'm just all about memories. I'm kind of just goofing around. Just kidding. Yeah, she loves the memories. And now it's raining. Now it's all also about to talk about this game Pseudo Legendary, which appears here, which is actually Gumi. It's a dragon type. Pure dragon type all the way. If it's in Sligo, when it evolves in Sligo, it's able to learn we need to have my repel stop since there's a lot of strong Pokemon here. And there's also, when it evolves into Goodra, I need to level up by going level 50 in the raid outside in the thing, actually. That's how you evolve it. Okay, battling. Look what I found! It's a trainer. How can you eyeball? Intimidate. Let's hope that didn't happen. But then again, was I expecting lava? Now, being a poison type, I want a new design. Let me just give a good buff on you and use Mega Evolution and get rid of you. There we go, that's good. That's my Lucario! Then that Pywar, that's a normal type, right? Oh no. Also, I need to find a hex maniac here, since that one has something good. Where'd you go? I need to find a hex maniac here. You might be the Hexmaker. I've known forever since my peeps life that he would be here again today, big shot. Do you know me or something? But I'm a total stranger. You cannot have flame body. You cannot have flame body. I'm pretty sure you have flash fire. Oh yeah, Anina? Are you Anima? Bomb Hexman, yes. You're probably the only Hexman that here? Yes, you are. Liquid can only have please not flame body. Flash fire and flame body. Please not have flame body. You have flame body, continue. You don't have any burn heals. I was talking about Honker, but yeah, here it is. Looks like a really final evolution is kind of interesting. It's a fast special sweeper. It has a special attack set of 145. It's not, yeah. It's literally its special attack set. I really need to get rid of this thing right now. Why did not think of that? Oh, it doesn't actually matter since Dark Side is half damage. It's just a fireless thing. Sucker Punch. But that's a priority and always hit if it's a Pokemon attack, like my Sucker Punch and you can swat. But it does not attack if you like a status inflicting. Boosting your stats up. Inflicting Thunder Wave or something like that. Once the land slash, no thanks. No, you do have scratch, but no. I lost? What wizardry is this? Just want to rewrite the laws of casualty? Causality, I'm pretty sure. Let me talk to you right now. I just obey. If that is what the fate is dedicated, I then I shall obey. Okay, you're creepy. Should be putting even more of those actions here, so not just her. Yeah, you're a hacksman yet, you mean from there. Yes, yes, yes. And look at the swamp. I can't think of a poison. I'm sorry. That really wasn't a very interesting thing to say. He picked this in a pleasant apology. GMO6 Toxic. Almost every Pokemon can learn this. The more toxic which poison type Pokemon use always hits, and the more poison damage from toxic gets worse every time. It's called Valley Poison. Yes. A lot of Pokemon can learn this move. Like almost every single one. It's like a universal PM. Also, you find a damn wise which, ironically, that's a super damn. Okay, I got that out of the way. There's also another TM here. Let me look at it real quick on my, South of Fairy Tale Girl in Mogan. Okay. The ninja sent me over there. Let me look at it if I can find like a Fairy Tale Girl. It's like kind of easy to see, though. Come on, this way! So this is the house. It is a scary house, isn't it? Well, I guess you should go inside. What? You're going inside? Are you all serious? Serena is off spending time with her Pokemon, so I guess we'll just have to go in without her. Let's see if the rumor is true by ourselves. I guess so. Let's just go inside by ourselves then. This moment. Let's get started then. It was a dark and stormy night. Many years ago, lost, I arrived at this house and went inside. The lights were not turned on, so I physically looked around the house. Eventually, I made my way into the kitchen. There was no sign of anyone being here. On the fridge, and when I opened it, a faint light blinked out. Finally make out my surroundings, then I saw the faint outline of the man howling in the corner of the room. I tried to tell him that I was lost and was hoping he'd let me stay until the morning. This camera sucks! Hoping he'd let me stay until the morning, but when I approached him, the man suddenly screamed, "Stay back!" I apologized and continued to complete my case. "Please, can't you help me?" "I'm not talking to you!" he shouted. I looked at the man in surprise. When I did this, the man asked me, "Can't you see them? Behind you, a horde of faceless men!" I tried to make myself sound a little bit scary, but nope, it sucks. And now then, since I told a wonderful story that will always haunt you, would you be so kind as just to tip me? If you don't, you might be really scary. You're charging us? Even haunted houses sound for you, though. Jeez, let's get out of here. There's a door already. I wasn't really listening. Was the story you just told really true? I doubt it. I guess it was a scary house in a way. Well, yeah, I know you wanted to go camping, and that's the kind of thing, I guess. People usually tell scary stories about the campfire, right? I've had enough of dark places and scary things. I'd rather rehearse my dance. I'll see you all later. What should I go next? I guess I'll go to Labyrinth City. See you later, Second Thing Itself. Please compare Pokedexes with me again soon. Let's see, is to go here? I can't tell since the swamp will give me problems and make me slow. I can't go there yet. I know now why I was wondering why that. Yeah, that's not the house we got from. You get something stuck. I need cut for that, and I don't have cut. No, actually, yes. Okay, now I've got here. Welcome to Labyrinth City. Every time you go here,
you get a
big mushroom. Every time you can get to go here and get a big mushroom. There is a big sheep here. That's good. Let me look at this place and the rares they have for me. Oh, you have me. You have that. You also have a black feather. That's good. I'm able to look a little bit less hideous. Okay, so I got this one, and the accessory was the black feather. There we go. That looks good. Yeah, that looks good. And now for the reason why I needed that Gengar. Let's put this in. There we go. I need Gengar for this. If you go, let's talk to you. It's mysterious. Something's very mysterious. An ability called Pixelate somehow turns normal type moves into fairy type moves. Yes, that's true. All the only Pokemon that has this are Mega Gardevoir and a Pokemon called Sylveon. Yeah, that's an evolution. I need to search for a Hex Maniac here. You are the one. What's this? I see. Perhaps training has accomplished as you get the most out of this. Gengar rides! Come on. You gotta tell me, how in the world did you get a Gengar? It's inconceivable. Do you have a friend who will trade Pokemon with you? So, what is this Mega Gengar? What does this Gengar ride do for you? What is Mega Gengar? Well, why don't we encounter a Pokemon and let's see whoever is my Mega Gengar? And also, after that, here comes the legendary Pokemon. Comes an ice battle against legendary Pokemon. Oh wait, I saw this pathway. Got an ether!
Ether.
Blah, blah, blah. This is the closest here. Okay, this crap size can be invasive here. Mega Gengar. Despite this thing doesn't even have any. Mega
Gengar is a very, 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 very strong special attack. It's one of the most famous special attackers out there. Its ability, a shadow attack, so it doesn't even get... So its special attack stat and speed, stupidly enough, is increased. That's basically how this thing is a Pokemon. So yeah, I'll now show you how this thing is a Pokemon, and I'm done here. I hope you enjoyed. I will see you guys next time for when we are going to tackle on the gym. I do will take some off-screen training with the actual. Yeah. I will see you guys next time. But after the legendary Pokemon. Ha ha ha. Thanks to go get that Megastone. Anyways, the Desert Boons. Right, right, down, down, then use strength. I push your stats. Let me think here. I know that my Relicanth has strength, and I also need to switch him up to Hades. I have to rock smash. Ah, no! Oh, no, 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 no! I only have rock smash here. Strength, which one of my friends can learn that? Wailord, apparently, since I need strength to do this. Miss. It's not Rock Smash. It was Rock Smash and Emerald. We need to go get. We need to do left, left, down, down, and then use Rock Smash. While in Ruby, Sapphire, and Oras, it's strength. I suggest doing the D-pad from this. That makes things a lot smoother. Actually, let's do this. Actually, I have Hades extra strength, which I ironically. So Hades, do this, and it's gonna be smashing. Also, one thing I almost forgot to mention, Groudon and Kyogre are shiny locked, and Azelf, Yuxi, Mesprit, and the other Pokemon here. Every single Pokemon you do need to fight in the main, when you encounter during their stories, they are not shiny locked. There's this, like, even this big guy right here is not shiny locked. So, without further ado, let's go into this battle right here.
Yay!
Regirock appears! Regirock! Rock type! Okay. Clear body force ability, Bulldoze, Curse, Aging Power, and Iron Defense. In case you don't know how this Pokemon is built, as a Pokemon, this thing is very bulky, and it hits hard. That Aging Power of him does not do much. It has a base stat of 200 in its physical defense. Which is really awesome, by the way. This is one of those Pokemon that gets basically like underestimated like a lot. Okay, there we go. Regirock is at perfect health, and those iron defenses does all just wonders. It does really wonders.
Rockstar became one of the most powerful types, and there's neither Pokemon here which ironically some types you don't even expect to be bulky, even though there are neat legendary Pokemon which are. It's a nice type legendary which is supposed to be very bulky, and that fails the job at it. Alright, now the Captain Regirock. I really don't like the moves that they gave him in Emerald, Sapphire, and Ruby and Sapphire, basically. They gave him Rockrow. I'll rethink here. Rockrow. Superpower. Agent Power. And Curse. And same moveset against the other two, and all except for Icy Wind and Glass Cannon? Pretty sure. But here they have the same moveset. Which is really awkward. Also, I really like the music. Good, but they somehow, they had every single generation have this, these three appearing. In Pokemon, of course, they appear of course here. In Pokemon Sapphire Emerald, of course, Aura, of course. In Pokemon Platinum, you're gonna get a bit of a Regigigas event. In Black 2 and White 2, they gave you this Pokemon. It's like, are you kidding me? And every time you see Regirock, 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 Registeel, like these guys, appealing, then you know that Regigigas is somewhere out there, and I hate his puzzle. With a burning passion.
It's okay,
okay, but really finicky. I will explain it when we get to the most important of those three, basically.
Oh yeah, the Regice one.
Yes, the Regice one.
I wasn't going to be a trouble for me.
Yeah,
it
did.
I basically had to retry him. Before I even
know I've been through this whole time. Yes, even though what you need to do to get Regigigas, you need to capture all of these three, have your party, and give Regieyes a nickname out of three items, and just randomize every single playthrough. I can get two of them right now, but I will do this after I've captured all three of them. Plus, I do not have the time at the correct time to capture all of these three, actually. It's supposedly at the data lab. It's supposed to be referencing the anime, ironically, where Regigigas comes out of a blue light, sometimes like that. Yeah, I have good commentary, like, referencing everything, like, on the anime, basically. Okay, so many anime references, and Red and those three are busy. Yuki Mess and Acid are anime references, ironically. Yuxi is supposed to be referencing of Brock with rock hard defenses and eyes are creeping me out. Mesprit very emotional like Dawn and all around like it's supposed to be really all around, it's confirmed. Yes, an ass love is based off ass. Blue clothes, a sash, and a hat.
No way my favorite of this kid can be,
Plus, it begins with an A. Yes, I'm not kidding. It's supposed to be referencing ash of all clothes.
That is the whiny, whiny kid.
Well, the kid is not whiny X and Y. He has character development from part 1 when he stepped out of the plane. He's a really different kid now. Do you want to know the differences right now?
Okay.
He is a little badassery. He's risky and is real. What I mean by risky? Okay, let me just say it right now. He risks his own life to save his own Pokemon. Like, he jumps off Prison Tower just to save his Pikachu. He let him hurt himself just to get the, his strategy up for his training for like Gust for Pavilion. For Noivon Gust. He jumps into a pool, almost gets back from a pool of lava, just to rescue his town flame after he was defeated by Moltres. He blasts a vacuum with his own body just to stop Swirlix from getting too dizzy. He's really risking his own life for saving his own Pokemon. And now, with the introduction of Ash,
would you risk
your life for Pokemon if they're living? Yes, I do risk your life, but he is taking it to the extreme.
So he is really a hero, because everybody would do that.
Yes, but he is a lot more, a little more serious, and let's just say a lot more, really more badass. And every time he does do get a little some jokey moments. Actually, he does get some jokey moments, but they are funny. Plus they also reintroduce a old joke and remix it. You know how much every beautiful lady. What comes at them is like, please marry me! Now Bonnie does that too with every punk lady. Please take care of my brother! It's so funny. It's a good show. It's Gen 6, they're really good. However, I do suggest watching the Japanese one since the music. In the English dub is not very fitting with these things. And Regirock, you are giving me much trouble, I should be clear. But he was trying to capture a normal Pokemon, which is ironically. I'm pretty sure he captured a Regirock in his MLS play into a Premier Ball? He captures Regieye very quickly in a Ultra Ball, Registeel in a Pokeball, Rayquaza full health in an Ultra Ball, Groudon little health in a Next Ball, which is extremely rare, where he lost a lot of man points and he screams everyone's ears out, and Ultra Ball and Kyogre, and it took him a long time.
Oh yeah, what is your luckiest moment in Pokemon?
My luckiest moment? That's supposed, I guess you can say... my luckiest moment. That is a very tough situation, actually. So it's supposed to be luckiest moment? I guess it's supposed to be Heatran. No, not the Heatran. Terrakion in Pokemon Black 2. I captured in one Pokeball.
Okay.
That sounds like
it. Did you find Pokemon?
Yeah, I did.
Well, I was playing Pokeball, I had to fight Ho-Oh, you know?
Yes.
So I was like, okay, fuck this, I'm going to throw a Pokeball. I'm going to Pokeball. Guess what happened?
You captured him?
Yes.
Yes. Like, Shurikoi is always, like, known to capture legendary Pokemon in normal Pokeballs. He did that with Mangle the Regis. He captured Groudon in a stupid Pokeball. He captured Suicune's Pokemon Soul Silver in a Pokeball. He captured Zapdos in a Pokeball after all of his Pokeballs failed. It's just so many Pokeballs have been captured. Most legendary Pokemon have been captured of him in Pokeballs. And now Pokemon Platinum. Oh, we're gonna be having. We have legendary Pokemon. That's always a funny moment. It's always a funny moment. And Shurikoi meets legendary Pokemon. It's gonna be him a pain to catch all the Pokemon. Let me see here. He had a really stupid moment where Camera used Earthquake on Entei. And of course, his lucky moment is there is where no type and ground type moves hit him every time with his Mistweezer. Where he did that, he made the counter of it, and see, Raikou captured not very long ago. He had two chances against Venus Suicune, since apparently he took it a long time where a Shadow Rush killed himself. their recoil, which sucks, by the way. And they, of course, fainter than what, and not much since Ho ironically is giving you by as gifts, and Shadaluga, he captured him easily, and Legendary Burst took him also a little while. And Cannon Regirock, please get in the ball. I'm almost losing it by almost. This is basically what the supposed to be legendary Pokemon supposed to be doing. It took 1 minute to an hour. That's basically how these legendary Pokemon go on. And that's also why they keep reminding you to save every so often, because of the these guys not only are as strong, but if you accidentally KO them, you may want to reconsider it. Excuse me. Okay, this guy is giving me too much trouble. I'm gonna have 242 Pokeballs by now, but still. I know I'm overprepared, but I don't care right now.
Oh, I'm not saying oh my god because you're overprepared. I'm saying oh my god because Virus Hash, my Link Amigo, has really been stepping up his game lately. He's being overpowered as fuck.
I just like I'm really looking at every single time. If I'm lucky right now, I can capture your favorite legendary Pokemon. No, I cannot. I need to wait until your favorite legendary Pokemon isn't even captured here, since you see it on the screen right now.
Wait a second.
Okay. Okay, I'm really struggling right now, but I can't go. I'm pretty sure your yawn might go worse. Okay, I know, I'm pretty sure many people are going to complain. How do you get a shiny? It's random luck. I'm going to have yawn it since I need to go to sleep. Yay, you didn't, you little idiot. I need to at least grab a revive. Yes, I have. Hades, I need your help. If it does another Iron Defense, I will be really nice. Thank you so much. Now we'll be sleeping. Wrong item. Also, since there's no room legendaries, I suggest watching it, using this in case there's something crazy going to happen. And I did good. I just captured Regirock right now.
Good job, you did it.
Took me a long time. Okay, I'm now going to be by far the weirdest puzzle in the entire game. You already have rest. Oh no, that's rest. That's probably yawn or shit. Anyways. Puchiana is leveling up.
Wow.
How? 5. 6, 7, Sand Attack, 8, 9, okay, there we go.
Only level 9?
It's mental level, gentlemen. Rock Pete Pokemon,
see what that's nice.
Regirock was sealed away by people long ago. If this Pokemon body is damaged in battle, it is said to seek out suitable rocks on its own to repair itself. Ah, you have the stubby legs. Stubby arms, actually.